You know, talking about the books of heaven and how to present them in the courts of heaven. I feel like that we not only have we had some information, but we've actually got some things done.
And for
our own personal lives now. But also maybe knowing how to operate here as we move from here. Because that's really what I want to do is be able to equip so that when we're all done, you can still do this. I remember when I first encountered the courts of heaven, it was like this huge mystery to me. I never heard a teaching on the courts of heaven. In fact, to this day, I've never heard a teaching on the court of heaven.
事实上，直到今日，我都还没有听见别人教导天上法庭。
But I watched this particular group, I watched them doing it.
但是我看到这样的一群人，我经历的一群人，他们做这样的事。
And I didn't know what they were doing.
那事实上那时候不明白他们在做什么。
I was watching them, and I could feel things moving in the spiritual atmosphere.
那我观看他们所做的，我就感觉到那属灵的氛围改变。
Remember, I'm a feeler. I feel things.
你记得我是一个感受型的人吗？ 我就感受到一些事情。
And I could feel all this movement and activity in the unseen world.
我就可以感受到在看不见的领域里面许多的事情在改变跟运作。
But I didn't know what they were doing.
但是我不明白他们所做的。
And of course, I talked to them afterwards a little bit.
那之后我跟他们交谈。
But then the Holy Spirit just really started personally teaching me about the courts of heaven.
那圣灵就亲自来教导我有关天上法庭。
And helping me to understand the legal realm of the Spirit.
那帮助我明白在属灵界的里面什么叫做合法的定位。
Because even years prior to that encounter, I had become aware that there was something very legal about the spirit world.
我就发现在灵界里面有关乎什么是合法，什么是不合法。
I couldn't explain it, but I just knew it in the spirit.
我虽然那时候不能解释，但我灵里有感受。
But after those encounters, God started showing me from the Bible what was going on.
但那次经历之后，神就借着圣经向我启明当时所经历的。
And he helped me to be able to create language that can help people get a hold of the court of heaven.
那帮助我能够发展出一套语言的系统，也帮助人来认识这个天上的法庭。
The Apostle Paul had spoken Corinthians about comparing spiritual things with spiritual things.
那使徒保罗在哥林多前书那里就讲到说，属灵的事与属灵的事相比。
And sometimes that's a very difficult thing to do because our natural words don't always seem to express what we know is going on.
因为很多时候我们自然人的言语有限制，不足以来形容天上所发生的事情。
And yet God helps us.
但是神是我的帮助。
He causes us to know how to move in faith.
他使我们在信心中前行。
So we have covered quite a bit of territory, and I want to take us just a little further this afternoon.
那之前我们已经教导了许多，但今天下午我们要持续的前进。
So even though we may think we know everything about Daniel 7, 9 through 10, that's what I want to read.
那这虽然我们觉得我们好像已经常常讲到但以理书第七章第十节，但是我们今天下午仍然要以这节经文开始。
And I'm just going to tell you, what we're going to talk about today is how to go from being a defendant in the court of heaven to operating as a judge.
那今天下午我们所要讲的就是如何在天上的法庭从一个被告人的身份进入到一个审判官的地位。
Because I've been teaching on the course now for going on 10 years.
因为我现在教导天上法庭近几乎10年了。
For the biggest part of that, I was approaching the court from a defendant position.
那大部分的时间，那时候我就进入到天上法庭是带着一个被告人的身份。
Because I felt like that all I did in the court was to get the devil off of me.
那我本来想就是我就是上天上的法庭那个脱掉撒旦对我的种种控制。
So that I can have what was in my book.
以至于我可以得着我书卷中所记载的。
And that is a part of operating in the court.
那的确这是天上法庭运作的一部分。
But that's not everything.
但这还不完全。
In fact, I think that it's almost like of beginning the beginning stages of operating in the court.
事实上，我觉得那只是天上法庭运作的起端。
Because if that's the place we stay, then we're always in a defendant's mindset and posture.
因为如果天上法庭只是这样子的话，那我们就永远是处在一个被告人的思维和运作的里面。
And we're always repenting and trying to revoke the legal rights of Satan.
那我们总是在认罪悔改，总是要推翻那个撒旦对我们的种种控诉。
Which is a part of the courts of heaven.
那的确这是天上法庭的一部分。
And we have to go there and do that.
那我们必须要上到法庭做这样的事。
But I discovered there's a higher level of operation in the courts.
但是我发现在天上的法庭还有更高层的一种运作。
So let's read in Daniel 7 verses 9
through 10. 最好不好？让我们回到但以理书第七章。
The Bible begins begins these verses by saying, "I watched till thrones were put in place."
那第九节开始说，我观看见有宝座设立。
So there is going. He's about to describe what he's seeing in the unseen world.
他正在要开始描绘他在人眼不可见的那个领域里面看见了什么。
And he is going to describe the operation of the courts of heaven.
同时要来描绘天上法庭正在运作的光景。
We know that because at the end of verse 10 it says the courts are open and the books are, or the courts are seated and the books are open.
我们怎么哪里得知呢？就是第十节的后半段，他说他坐着要行审判。
But this all begins with this statement, I watched till thrones were put in place.
但是这一切就看都是从哪里开始呢？就是我观看见有宝座设立。
So notice that the beginning of the operation of the courts
就是在天上法庭运作的开始
starts with thrones being put into place.
从宝座被设立开始。
Okay, thrones being put into place is speaking of those who have qualified to sit in realms of spiritual authority.
宝座设立就是说有人合格能够足以坐在天上的宝座上。
And these are not just talking about heavenly beings.
这些讲的并不只是天上的活物而已。
I mean, we know that in Revelation chapter 4, we see 24 elders sitting on 24 thrones.
那在启示录第四章那里，我们也看到有24长老坐在24个宝座上。
And by the way, I do know that the Chinese Bible does not say thrones, but throne here.
那在但以理书第七章第九节那里只讲到宝座，只是看起来像单数的，事实上是复数。
But in the original text, it is thrones plural.
但是在原文里它是复数的。
And again, Romans or Revelation 4 clearly says around the throne of God are at least 24 thrones with elders sitting on them.
那我们看到启示录第四章那里清楚写到，除了至高者的宝座之外，还有24位长老的宝座。
So there are thrones around the throne.
所以在神的宝座之外，还有其他的宝座围绕着。
We know that some of those thrones would be occupied by heavenly beings.
那我们知道那些宝座是天上活物的宝座。
I mean, I always assumed, for instance, the elders that are sitting upon those thrones.
那我常常以前想，就是只有长老配坐在那些宝座上。
Remember, as the worship begins to go forth.
当我们开始在天上有敬拜的时候。
As the four living creatures cry out, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty."
那四活物就说圣哉，圣哉，圣哉，万军之耶和华。
These 24 elders fall off their thrones.
那这24位长老就从宝座下来。
And cast their crowns. Toward the throne.
将他们的皇冠献在这神的宝座面前。
And they are crying out, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain."
他们就说，那曾被杀的羔羊是配得称颂的。
So I have always taught.
那我过往所领受的教导。
That those 24 elders must be from the earth.
那24位长老一定是从地上去的。
In other words, they are people. That lived such a life in the earth.
就是说那些人在地上，他活着这样的一个敬虔的生活。
That they qualified to sit upon these thrones.
以至于他们合格可以坐在天上的宝座上。
Because they have crowns.
因为他们头上有冠冕呢。
The Apostle Paul.
那宝石的宝。
He said there was a crown of righteousness laid up for him.
那他就说有公义的冠冕为他存留。
In the book of James, it speaks of a crown of life.
那雅各书也讲到有生命的冠冕。
And there's many different crowns that are spoken of in the New Testament.
在新约里提到不同种的冠冕。
The Bible talks about being crowned with loving. loving kindness and mercy.
那就圣经也提到说，就是那恩慈良善的冠冕。
But clearly from what Paul said, crowns are rewards for having served the Lord faithfully.
那保罗清楚的指明说，冠冕是因着我们忠心服侍主所带来的奖赏。
And of course, when we think about a crown, we're thinking about somebody that is recognized. In a ruling position.
那当我们想到冠冕的时候，我们也想到那些配得冠冕的人，他们就是有一个执政掌权位分。
Kings and those that are in authority have crowns.
就是王和那些有在权的人，他们就有冠冕。
They signify the position they hold.
标志出他们所持有的位分。
And the authority they operate in.
和他们掌有的权柄。
So when these 24 elders fall.And cast their crowns.
当这二十四位长老俯伏在宝座，把他们的冠冕放在宝座前。
What they are saying is that if it were not for your grace, Lord Jesus, I would not have this.
他们就表明说，若不是借着主耶稣基督宝的恩典的话，我们就不会有这些。
It is your grace that empowered me to live the kind of life.
唯有借着耶稣的恩典，使我们得力能够活出这样的生活。
That caused me to win this crown.
就是保罗竭力要赢得的冠冕。
I could not have done this outside your grace.
就是若我们没有在基督的恩典里面的话，我们就做不成这样的事。
So when they fall and cast their crowns at his feet,
以至于当长老俯伏在神的面前，将宝座冠冕放在他脚前。
They are not only declaring the worthiness of the Lord with their mouth.
他们不单单用嘴来说神是配得荣耀的。
But they are signifying it with the action of casting their crowns before him.
那同时借着他们的行为，他们就把冠冕放在神的面前。
You are worthy.
就是主，你是配得。
But these are beings that are on a heavenly throne.
那这些都是在天上宝座坐的国物。
Now let me give you a definition for a throne.
那什么是宝座？
A throne is a governmental, judicial, or legislative seat.
那宝座就是一个治理的、司法的、执政的、有权柄的一个位置。
For instance, it says in the book of Proverbs.
意思就是，比如说在箴言书里面。
When a king sits on his throne.
当王坐在宝座上。
He scatters evil with his eyes.
他的眼睛就是仇敌四散。
In other words, the battle, if you will, or the struggle is to get into the throne.
那意思，我们人生最大的挣扎或我们的征战，就是要能够进入到我们的宝座。
Once you're in the throne,
一旦我们坐上我们的
宝座 the authority that you're operating from,
那我们就有权柄可以开始运作。
Everything has to obey it.
那凡我们有了权柄之后，万物都要伏在我们的脚下。
Because a king doesn't have to say a word.
因为王不需要多说一个字。
He says he scatters evil with a look.
他光是瞪他一眼，仇敌就要四散。
That's authority.
这就是权柄。
That's authority.
这就是权柄。
You see, our struggle is to get into the throne, into the seat.
我们的挣扎就是如何坐到我们的宝座上。
Now, one of the things that God showed me several years ago.
几年前神向我显明一件事。
Is that.In one phase of my life, I thought operating under the anointing was like the ultimate thing.
但曾经在我的生命里面，我觉得如果能够在恩膏下来运作的话，那就是最厉害的了。
Because it is the anointing oil that destroys the yoke.
因为那恩膏的油使轭折断。
Isaiah 10:27.
那以赛亚书十章二十七节。
And so I thought, if I'm anointed,
那我就觉得若我是
高高的。That's the pinnacle.
那这就是我们那个可以达到最高点。
And maybe I want even a greater anointing.
是，或者我要得到更大的恩膏。
But then I discovered something.
后来我就发现一件事。
It's one thing to be anointed.
那得恩膏是一件事。
It's another thing to operate in authority.
但是如果你按着你的权柄行事，是完全另外一回事。
There is anointing and authority.
那有恩膏，有权柄。
But operating in authority is another level.
但是按着你的权柄来行事，这是另外一个层次。
In Matthew 10:1-2.
马太福音第十章第一节到第二节。
The Bible says that he called his disciples to him.
那神叫了他十二个门徒来。
And he gave them power.
给他们权柄能力。
But the word there is exousia in the Greek, which is authority.
那权柄在这个希腊文字就是刚刚他讲那个词。
See, the word power is dunamis.
那 能力其实是 dunamis 在希腊文里
which is more about anointing
那就比较关乎恩膏
exousia is about authority
但 exousia 是关乎权柄
or right to operate
那就是有权利能够来执行
I'll explain it this way
让我用这方式来解释
a policeman in Hong Kong
在香港的一个警察
He has on a uniform and a badge
他穿着制服带着徽章
That makes you recognize him as an authority
使你能够看见他带着权柄
You behave around him
那你在他的周遭你就会比较约束自己
But in America, I guess here, maybe he has a gun
在美国可能警察还带着配枪
The authority he has
他身上所承载
gives him the right to use the gun
给他那个权利能够使用他所带的配枪
If I go out and use a gun
如果我自己随便出去乱使用枪
I'm in trouble
我就陷入麻烦中
Because I don't have the uniform in the bag
因为我没有这样的一个制服和徽章
I'm using a power
我现在使用一个能力
I don't have authority to use
但是却没有这样一个权利可以使用这个能力的
But the policeman has the authority
但警察他有这样的一个权柄
Backed up by the government
就是政府所加诸给他的权柄
To use the gun
能够来使用配枪
Okay, now whether we agree or not
不管我们是否同意
That's the principle
但是这是我们所
Okay
See,
when the Bible says in Matthew 10,
在圣经在马太福音第十章那里说
that he called the disciples to them,
耶稣叫了他十二个门徒来
he gave them authority,
给他们权柄
not power,
不是能力
he didn't give them dunamis,
他不是给他 dunamis,
he didn't give them anointing,
他也不是给他们恩膏
he gave them authority,
他给他权柄
And the Bible's the very next phrase says,
那下一句话就说
and the 12 apostles are.
那十二个门徒
And he begins to list their names.
然后开始讲他们每一个人的名字。
So here's the principle.
那原则
The disciples went from disciples to apostles.
那门徒变成使徒。哦，对不起，第二节就开始讲十二个使徒的名字。所以他们从门徒变使徒。
Based on the authority Jesus gave them.
他们能够这样的改变，乃是根据于耶稣所赐给他们的权柄。
Not the anointing.
不是恩膏。
You see, anointing doesn't make you an apostle.
恩膏不能使你成为一个使徒。
The authority you carry in the spirit world.
但是你在灵界里所承载那个权柄，使你成为一个使徒。
You see, when someone has been called and set as an apostle,
如果一个人蒙召要被设立有成为一个使徒
，they have an authority in the spirit world.
他们在灵界里就有一个权柄。
And when they function there, atmospheres change.
当他们在灵界里运行的时候，氛围就会改变。
Because of the authority they carry.
因着他们所承载那个权柄。
Okay. So my point is, there's a difference between anointing and authority.
所以我的重点就是说，恩膏跟权柄是有所不同的。
There's a difference between dunamis and exousia.
就是 dunamis 跟 exousia 是有不同的。
Okay. So.I found out that God did not just want me functioning in anointing.
所以我就发现神不单单要我在恩膏里面运行。
He wanted me also to begin to occupy a place of authority.
他同时开始希望我在权柄的一个位置上就位。
Which can involve anointing.
那可以，这个就位可能会有恩膏的参与。
But it's a higher level.
但是却是一个更高的层面。
It's a new dimension.
是一个新的层面。
That God would want us to function in.
一个新的等次，神要我们运行。
I'll tell you this.
我要来告诉大家。
One of the ways we get authority.
我们如何得到权柄
？Is by fighting battles and winning.
就是我们要来在征战中而并且得胜。
You see, if you ever have to.Fight through a situation.
就是当每当你必须要经过一场征战
and you conquer it.
然后你得胜
you now have mastery over.
那如今你就在这件事上胜过
you now rule that area.
如今你就在这件事上你掌权
and you have something that you can give to somebody else.
以至于你有一个实质可以拥有的东西，而且你可以分赐给别人的
See, for instance, if someone was This happens quite often. If someone was healed of a very terrible disease,
比如说有一个人从非常不容易的一个疾病中被得到医治的话
and they use their faith to grab hold of who Jesus is and what he did.
那他们就使用信心来紧紧抓住耶稣在十字架上所为他成就的。
And they obtained their healing.
他们就得着医治之后。
Then quite often they can now give healing.
那如今他们就常常看见这样的人，他们就能够把这。
Because they fought through something.
因为他们经历了这样的征战。
And they didn't just get healed.
他们不单单自己得到医治。
They obtained a place in the spirit world.
同时在灵界里，他们得到。
So they can now give that to somebody else.
以至于他们可以开始把这个分赐给别人。
Amen. Amen. You see, God wants to teach us how to do this.
所以谁要来教导我们如何做这个事？
Because it's one thing to be anointed.
那你知道得恩膏不是一回事。
It's another thing to have authority.
但是拥有权柄是另外一回事。
And we all have struggles we go through.
那我们每一个人都经历过人生的挣扎。
But if we would realize.
但若我们明白。
That what God wants to do
神在我们生命中想要做的
is to move us into a realm of authority
就是使我们能够进入到一个权柄的位置
so we can say like Peter did
以至于我们可以像彼得一样
such as I have, I give it to you
凡我所有的我都分给你
Amen,
Amen.
Now keep your place there but go to 2 Corinthians
让我们去一下哥林多后书
God wants to elevate us and give us places of authority.
神要提升我们，使我们进入到一个权柄的位置。
Now we haven't got to the throne yet.
那我们现在还没有到宝座的位置哦。
But I want to show you this principle.
但我现在要跟大家分享这个原则。
In 2 Corinthians,
在哥林多后书
and chapter 1,
第一章
verse 3. It says, Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy and God of all comfort.
愿颂赞归于我们的主耶稣基督的父神，就是发慈悲的父，赐各样安慰的神。
Who comforts us in all of our tribulations, that we might be able to comfort those who are in any trouble with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God.
我们在一切患难中，他就安慰我们，叫我们能用神所赐的安慰去安慰那些遭各样患难的人。
The Apostle Paul said, God comforts us.
那使徒保罗在这里告诉我们说，神安慰我们。
In our troubles,
在患难之中安慰我们。
He actually allows us to walk through places of trouble.
他允许我们经历各样的患难。
So that in those places we experience His comfort.
以至于我们在患难之中能够经历到他的安慰。
So that we now can take that comfort we have received.
使我们运用神所赐给我们的安慰。
And minister it to others who are in trouble.
我们能用这样的安慰去安慰一切其他遭患难的人。
So that they can be comforted.
以至于他们也可以得到安慰。
In other words,
万人之。
God allowed the Apostle Paul and his people.
神允许使徒保罗和其他人。
To go through hard places.
那经历过人生种种。
So that they would win victories.
以至于他们得胜。
So that they could then give that victory to somebody else.
也能够把他们得胜分赐给别人。
You see, we all want to run to school and go to school.
我们每一个人都上学。
And be trained in Bible things in Bible school.
我们喜欢上到神学院去领受或圣经学院领受圣经的教导。那这一切都没有问题。
But I promise you.
但我向你们承诺。
Real training for ministry.
那如你真的要得到事工上，你要想得到事工真正的补偿。
Happens when we have to use our faith to get through our own troubles.
就是说，真正的训练是当我们需要运用我们的信心来胜过我们的困难。
Because when I win victories in those places,
因为在那些困难之中，当我得胜
，I can now give it to somebody else.
我如今能将这个得胜的权柄来
，That's authority.
这就是权柄。
That's not just anointing.
但不，这不单是
That's authority.
恩膏，而是权柄。
Amen. So. The Apostle Paul said this to Timothy.
所以使徒保罗告诉提摩太说。
He said the farmer that develops a crop, the farmer that raises a crop.
到之前的来兴起一个庄稼。
Must be first partaker of that crop.
那先割庄稼人就是你收割的人他要先得庄稼。
See what is Paul saying to Timothy as a young minister?
那提摩太他是一个年轻服侍主的人，保罗在这里告诉他说。
He's saying don't try to give something to someone.
就是你不要尝试给别人一些东西。
That you haven't proved yourself.
就是你还没有在那件事情上证明自己的东西，你没有办法给出去。
That's, in other words, you gotta eat, eat what you're growing first.
就是你必须要先吃自己手所做的东西。
Because then we have a real authority.
因此我们才会得到真正的权利。
You know, in the courts of heaven,
在天上的法庭。
I, you know, as far as I know, maybe I was the first one, I think probably the first one to begin to teach on the courts of heaven.
我觉得我可能是首先教导天上法庭的人。
I still don't know of a lot of people that actually teach it.
那事实上，我现在所知道教导这个题目的人也不多。
There are people that have taken my stuff and they're teaching in different places.
那也有人真的拿了我的教材开始在
Which
上教材。我觉得这
是。It's wonderful. That's the way the message spreads.
那我也很高兴，因为这就是信息得以散播的方式。
But it's one thing to teach principles.
那教导原则是一回事。
It's another thing to carry an authority.
那但是你承载这样的权柄却是另外一回事。
Because authority comes out of what I've just described.
因为权柄是从我刚刚跟大家所形容的生出来的。
It comes out of having fought battles and won.
就是你必须要征战，并且在征战中得胜。
So now I've obtained a place in the spirit I can give something.
以至于我能够得到在属灵的一个位分。
But authority also comes out of revelation.
那权柄同时也借着启示出来。
I mean, if there's one thing I remember,
如果有一件事是我记得的话
about Watchman Nee's book on spiritual authority,
就是尼托生讲到属灵权柄的书。
It was that real spiritual authority comes from revelation.
就是说真正属灵的权柄来自于启示。
And that is true.
那这是真实的。
That when I have had an encounter with God,
当我与神有一次相遇。
And I know something from Revelation.
我借着启示领受一些新的事情。
That gives me an authority in that area.
那就让我在这件事情上有所权柄。
That's why when the Apostle Paul came out of the wilderness.
所以当使徒保罗从旷野中出来。
Not having learned justification of faith from man.
那并不是从人那里学到如何因信称义。
But having that revelation from God by the Spirit.
但是神在他的灵你亲自赐下这样的启示。
He could minister that truth with authority.
他就可以借着带着权柄来教导这样的。
Because revelation produces authority.
因为启示带出释放出权柄。
Let me show you a scripture in Galatians.
让我们看一下哥罗西书。
We're going to get to the seat to the throne here in just a moment.
我们等等要回到宝座上。
But I want to show you this. I'm going to find Galatians.I never learned the books of the Bible.
我对圣经的书卷不太熟，其实是
挺
超
新
鲜。
I have read it many times. I still don't know the order so often. The order.
我虽然读过圣经很多遍，但是我对圣经书卷的排序还是
很清楚。I'm sorry.
不好意思。
In Galatians, let me find. In Galatians, chapter 1,
加拉太书第一章
verse 15.
十五节。
He said, but when it pleased God who separated me from my mother's womb and called me through his grace,
然而那把我从母腹里分别出来又施恩召我的神
to reveal his son in me that I might preach him among the Gentiles.
既然乐意将他儿子启示放在我的心里又叫我把他在外
面 He said, I did not immediately confer with flesh and blood.
我就没有与属血气的人商量
but notice what he says.
你要留意他在
It was the revelation of the son.In him,
就是他神把他儿子的启示放在保罗的心里
that empowered him to preach.
是他有能力可以分享
One of our problems in the body of Christ,
在基督身体里面的一个问题
is that we got preachers preaching without revelation.
我们就是有很多的人讲传道，但是他们没有启示
I'm not saying they got to come up with a new idea.
我不是说他们一定要有一个新鲜的想法
but whatever they're preaching from.Ought to be from a deep revelation they have of the Lord themselves.
但他们所分享的必须要是在深深在他们心里从主那里得来的启示。
Because it is the revelation in them that will produce an authority from them when they preach.
就是唯有在他们心中领受了启示，当他们来分享这个信息的时候，才会带着权柄。
And that doesn't necessarily mean they're loud.
并不意味着他们讲话一定要很大声。
Loud doesn't mean authority necessarily.
大声并不意味着权柄。
Even though I'm loud.
虽然我讲话很大声。
I can't help it.
我没有办法。
My whole family's loud.
我们全家人讲话都很大声。
But The authority that you carry comes out of the revelation that you have.
在你身上所存在的权柄在乎你里面的启示。
I don't care if you're preaching Jesus loves me.
我不知道你是不是在只是分享说耶稣爱我。
It has to be preached from a revelation.
那纵然是这么简单的道理，都是要从启示里。
Because you will know in the atmosphere that's created.
因为你知道这个话语一旦释放出所形成的。
Whether somebody's doing that at a revelation or not.
那你会知道这个人所分享的是出于启示还是与否。
So Paul said.The revealed son that he had that was in him.
所以保罗说他神将他儿子的启示放在他心。
It empowered him to preach to the Gentiles.
使他能够在外邦人中传。
Amen.
Amen.
So I've said all that to say it's one thing to be anointed.
我讲这么多就是跟大家讲说在恩膏里运行是。
And to function in all sorts of a ministry.
或你可以在任何的事工里面服事。
But it's another thing to carry authority.
但是你承载权柄是另外一回事。
Which is another dimension of function in the spirit world.
乃是在灵界的里面，灵界的世界里另外一个层次、等次的服事。
So I realized I didn't just want to be anointed, I also wanted to carry authority.
所以我明白到，我不单单想要拥有恩膏，我还想要更要承载权柄。
So,I'm thinking when I saw the authority, I thought, okay, I've made it.
所以我当我看到我有权柄的时候，我就想，耶，很棒，我终于到了。
But then the Lord said, no, there's one more area.
但是主又告诉我说，还有另外一个。
It's called a seat of government.
就是讲到治理的宝座。
Or a throne.
或者宝座，治理的宝座。
I don't want you just to be anointed.
我不单单要你有恩膏。
I don't want you just to carry authority.
我也不单单要你承载。
I also want you to take a seat in the spirit world.
我同时希望在灵界的领域里面，你拥有一个宝座。
That is governmental, judicial, and legislative in nature.
就是治理，还有司法跟立法的一个本质。
That will let you function as a judge.
使你能够运作如同一个审判官。
Wow, I thought I've never heard such thing.
我是想说，我从来没有听过人家讲这样的事。
But in my spirit, I knew it was right.
但是我灵里知道这是正确的。
That God wanted me to take this seat.
神要我来拥有这个位置。
And then I began to think.
我就开始想。
Revelation 3:21.
就是启示录三章第十节。
Jesus said, "If you overcome as I overcame."
他说，如果你得胜，正如我得胜一样。
I will let you sit down with me in my seat.
我就要赐他宝座与我同坐。
And I have sat down with my Father in His seat.
就正如我在
Or His throne.
我在我父的宝座上与他同坐。
That's not talking about us going to heaven.
这不是讲到说我们要上到天堂。
Jesus says, "I'm wanting some people to get into their seat now."
就是主耶稣，我现在就希望看到我的百姓能够坐在他的位置上。
Amen.
Amen.
That when a king sits upon his seat,
当王坐在他的宝座
he scatters evil with his eyes.
他用眼目就可以驱散仇敌。
And I began to realize there were governmental seats in the spirit realm.
我就明白到在灵界的里面有属灵的宝座。
That God needs for us to occupy.
神要我们来坐在上面。
He needs for us to get into these seats.
他要我们能够坐在宝座上。
So that we can, from these seats, we can challenge the powers of darkness.
以致我们在宝座上可以挑战黑暗的权势。
And see their rights revoked.
看见他们所有法律上的立足点被推翻。
So that not only can God's will be done in our life,
以致神的旨意不单单在我们的生命中成就。
But His will can be done over cities and nations.
而且在城市和国家中都得以成就。
Amen.
Amen.
So I wanted to get into these seats.
所以我想要进入到我的宝座里。
Remember when the sons of Zebedee came, the mother came and said, "Let my two sons sit, one on your right hand, one on your left."
你记不记得西比泰儿子的母亲，就是说跟耶稣说，我要我的儿子一个人坐右，耶稣的右边，一个人坐左边。
She was asking that he would grant them two very strong seats of authority or thrones of government.That they could function in.
意思就是说，他在向主耶稣求说把，那个非常有能力、有治理权的那个两个宝座赐给他两个儿子。
Jesus said to them.
但耶稣就对他说
Can you drink the cup I'm going to drink?
我所喝的这杯你岂能喝呢
？Can you be baptized with the baptism I'm going to be baptized?
我所领受的岂是你所能领受的呢
？They said, Lord, we can.
他说我们可以。
And he said, you in fact will.
他说是的，你也会必将领受。
He said, but I can't give you those seats.
但这些宝座不是我能所能安排的。
It will be given to those for whom it has been prepared.
就是唯有那预备好自己人才能够做到。
So two very powerful principles about seats.
所以在关乎宝座有两个很重要的原则。
Number one, they already exist in the spirit world. God is simply waiting.Someone to occupy them.
首先，这些宝座已经在灵界里被设立好了，而且神在等着人能够坐上去那宝座。
There are empty seats in the spirit world.
在灵界的里面有一些空，宝座上是空的，空的。
That either someone hasn't qualified to sit in.
要不是人还没有合格能够坐在上面。
Or it's not time for someone to sit.
要不然就是他坐上去的时间还没有到。
But they are prepared and waiting.
但是这些都是已经预备好在等着的。
For the ones that are supposed to occupy them.
就等着那些必须要上到宝座的人。
To get in them.
能够来坐上去。
That's why we're reading in Daniel 7 verse 9.
所以当我们读到但以理书第七章第九节。
That Daniel watched and saw thrones or seats being put into place.
就是他看见宝座已经都设立好了。
Because it was time for those seats to be occupied.
因为如今是那些宝座上坐着人的时间到了。
Amen.
被占领的时间到了。
So, let me just fill in the blanks here.
让我在这里填充一下。
Anointing you receive as a gift.
恩膏是我们领受如同一个礼物一样。
We don't earn anointing.
我们不赢得恩膏。
We are anointed because it is a gift of God through the Holy Spirit.
我们被膏乃是从神借着圣灵所赐给我们的。
That we simply have accepted and received Jesus as Lord and Savior.
当我们接受耶稣成我们个人生命的救主时。
And God anoints us.
神就恩膏我们。
Amen.
Amen.
Authority is a result of the principle of alignment.
但是权柄在却是借着对齐的原则所获得的。
That we are aligned with God.
我们与神对齐。
And with those who are meant to represent God into our life.
而且与那些神量在我们生命中要我们对齐的人。
It's not enough for me just to be in alignment with God.
就是我们与神单单对齐还是不足的。
I also need to be in an alignment with those who represent God into my life.
那我同时要与那些代表神进入到我生命里的那些人来对齐。
And that should usually be someone that is apostolic.
那这样的人通常是使徒性的。
Because we come into an alignment with the apostolic,
因着我们与使徒性的人对齐
that allows us to now function in these levels of authority.
容让我们能够在这样的权柄的阶层里面运行。
Okay, I'm not here to teach on all that necessarily. I'm not here to teach on all that.
我现在在这里不是要准备教这些东西。
But just know that we are anointed because we received the gift.
那你们只要明白说，我们得受恩膏乃是因为我们接受了耶稣基督。
We walk in authority because we're in alignment.
那我们行走在权柄的里面，因着对齐的缘故。
Number three.
第三点。
We get to sit in a seat of government or a throne.
我们能够得以坐在一个治理的位置上，就是宝座上。
Because we overcome.
因着我们得胜。
We overcome.
我们得胜。
You see, Jesus said, "If you overcome."
耶稣告诉我们说，若我们得胜。
I'll let you sit in my seat with me.
我就会让你坐在我的宝座的旁边。
He said to James and John.
他就告诉约翰和雅各。
Can you drink the cup I'm going to drink?
你岂能我喝的这杯你岂能喝的
？Can you be baptized with what I'm going to be baptized with?
我所领受的洗礼是岂是你能够领受的呢
？Can you go through this?And endure and overcome.
你是否能经历这一切的种种，不但胜过，不但忍受，而且胜得胜
？Because seats of government are granted to those who overcome.
因为治理的宝座乃是赐给那些得胜者。
Amen.
Amen.
So once we are in that seat,
所以一旦我们上了那个治理的宝座
，we are now positioned in the spirit world.
我们在灵界里就已经就位。
To occupy something that could be a part of the court of heaven.
能够站立在一个所谓天上法庭的地方。
Okay, so let's go back to Daniel 7.
所以我们回到但以理书第七章。
He said, "I watched till these thrones were put into place."
他说我观看见有宝座设立。
That means somebody that means that there are thrones that are now in place that need to be occupied.
意思说宝座已经设立好了，等着人坐上去。
And that the court of heaven cannot operate on its highest level.
那天上的法庭不能进入最高层次的进行。
Until the right people are in these thrones.
直到正确的人坐在那些宝座上。
Heaven is waiting for the right people to get in the throne.
天堂在等候正确的人来坐在那些宝座上。
They have been put in place.
他们宝座已经设立好。
But are they occupied?
但是问题是上面有没有人？
You see, this is connected to the court of heaven and its operation.
所以这是关乎天上法庭和它的运作的。
So there are thrones in the spirit world.
所以在灵界里有宝座。
That needs for somebody to sit in them.
需要有人就位。
So let me just tell you what happened to me.
那我就跟大家分享我个人的经历。
I was in Hawaii with my wife.
我有一次跟我太太在夏威夷。
We had been there to do ministry.
我们去那边服事。
Sometimes people would ask me, "Does your wife travel with you?"
有些人就问我说，你太太是否跟你一起旅行？
I said sometimes, but not very often.
我说有些时候，但不是。
I said, but it's always amazing.
但是很有趣。
When I go to Hawaii,
当我只要去夏威夷，
she is sitting in the seat next to me.
她总是坐在我的旁边。
She's always on that plane.
她总是跟我坐同一班飞机。
So we had gone there to do some ministry.
所以我们就去了夏威夷去服事。
But then we were going to have a few days of vacation or holiday.
那之后呢，我们就会在那里多过几天度假。
So it's the second day of our holiday.
在我们度假的第二天。
I've already done several days of ministry.
那之前有几天我们已经服事完。
I mean, I don't know what I'm about to tell you. Why God couldn't talk to me while I was working.
当我在工作的时候，我不知道神要这样告诉我说。
But now I'm on holiday.
我现在已经在开始度假了。
And the second day of my holiday.
在度假的第二天。
I have this dream.
我就领受了一个梦。
And in this dream, an angel has appeared.
那在梦中，一个天使向我显现。
And he has an instrument in his hand.
他手中拿着一个工具。
And he puts his instrument in my shoe.
他就把这个工具放在我的鞋子里。
With my foot in my shoe.
就是我脚还穿在鞋子里的时候。
And he begins to move the instrument around.
他就开始拿着一个工具在我的鞋子里。
And I know he is cleansing my walk to another level.
我知道他在洁净我的脚步到一个更高的地层次。
So when he gets through doing that,
所以当他做洁净完之后，
suddenly there is a seat.That is in the hanging in the atmosphere.
突然之间，我就看到在空中有一个宝座吊着。
And I look at that seat and think I can sit in that seat.
那我就看着那个宝座，就想说，哎，我可以坐上去哦。
So as I climb into the seat,
所以当我爬上那个宝座的时候，
I recognize when I get into the seat.
当我在爬进去宝座的过程中，
that this is a rocket propelled seat.
我就发现原来这是一个火箭带驱动的一个宝座。
And that there are controls for this seat.
那在宝座前有一切的那个控制盘。
And I remember I reached and I touched one of the controls.
我就记得我按了其中的一个钮。
And it jumped with such power that it scared me.
那这宝座冲了，带着这样的大力冲起往前走。
And I realized that even though I was sitting in the seat.
后来我就明白，就算我坐在宝座上。
I didn't know how to move in the seat.
我不知道在这个宝座上怎么前进。
That's very important.
这是很重要的。
Because so often we can occupy a place in the spirit.
因为很多时候我们可以在灵界里面占据一个位置。
But not really know how to operate from.
但是我们不知道怎么从那个位置上去行事。
God has to teach us how to move in that place.
神必须要教导我们在那个属灵的宝座上如何行事。
So I'm sitting in this seat.
所以现在我坐在宝座上。
And thinking.This thing is powerful.
我就想，哇，这个宝座好厉害。
So powerful it scares me.
到厉害到个地步，我有点怕了。
I don't know how to control it.
我都不知道怎么操作那个仪盘。
And suddenly the angel reappears.
所以天使又再次向我显现。
And he has three checks like notes of money.Appeared in his hand.
所以他手中呢拿着三张支票。
But it wasn't money.
但不是钱。
Written on the notes were requirements for me to sit in that seat.
那个支票上面就写的，我如果要坐在这个宝座上，我必须要履行的符合的标准。
There was three of them.
有三张。
I don't remember two of them. When I woke up, it was a blur.
那我醒来之后，其实三张中我只记得一张，另外两张不记得。
But one I remembered very clear.
但其中一张我记得非常的清楚。
That the Lord, and I'm not going to tell you what it was.
我不会告诉大家那个要求是什么。
The Lord said to sit in that seat.
那主告诉我说，如果你要坐在这宝座上。
There was this thing I could not do.
就有一件事是我不能做的。
That I had to abstain from something.
我必须要限制自己。
It wasn't an issue of right or wrong.
这不是对错的问题。
It wasn't like if I did it, it was right or it was wrong.
不是说我做了就对或错。
It was nothing moral or anything.
就不关乎道德的。
It was simply a point of obedience.
只是单单在顺服上。
And God said, "You must do this to sit in this seat."
那神吩咐我说，你一定要做这件事，以至于能够才能坐在。
So for the last 4 years, what He said to me, I have been completely obedient to.
那所以在这四年之后的四年，直到今日，我都顺服在这一点上。
Because I want to sit in that seat.
因为我真的很想持续。
I don't want to just have anointing.
我不单单想要有。
Or authority.
或者有权柄。
I want to sit in a judicial governmental seat of authority of a throne.
同时，我想要坐在一个治理司法那个立法的一个宝座上，就是对。
Because the Bible says, if you overcome.
因为圣经告诉我们，若我们得胜。
See, I watch what he's done for me.
因为我留意他在我生命中所做的。
There are things always that we are striving to overcome.
因为我们生命中总有一些事是我们竭力要得胜的。
We fight against the flesh and the temptation.
就是我们抵挡这个肉体和一切的。
All of us do this.
我们每一个人都经历这样的挣扎。
But those issues are important.
那这些事情的确很重要。
But I'm going to try to help you here.
但是我在这里想尝试帮助大家。
They are important, but sometimes.
虽然他们很重要，但有些时候。
In fact, I believe many times.
事实上，大部分的时候。
When God offers us a seat to sit in.
神当神给我们一个宝座，让我们坐上去的时候。
To sit in that seat will require accepting a restraint on your life.
就是你若想要坐在那个宝座上的话，一定会要接受一些在你身。生命中某种的限制。
Samson and but let me use Samson as example.
比如说，我用参孙做一个例子。
Samson was an immoral man.
那参孙是一个非常不道德的人。
We know that.
我们都知道。
He had a real problem with the women.
他真的在女性方面很有
问题。It was a real issue in his life.
那他真的很有大问题。
But as long as he kept the vow of a Nazarite. As long as he kept the vow of a Nazarite.
但是他只要持守那个拿西尔的约。的誓言
，which was to not touch a dead body，
就是不要触摸任何死的尸体
，to drink to take nothing from the vine，
或者不要喝任何的酒
，and not to cut his hair，
就是也不要剪他的头发。
As long as he did that，
他只要持守这些拿西尔的约
，God let him operate as a judge，
神就使他如同一个事实一样运作。
Because even though he was immoral，
所以虽然他过一个不道德的生活
，the obedience to the restraint God put on his life，
但是他顺服于神良。给他生命中的这一些限制
，caused him to function as a judge over Israel，
使他就能够做足以做以色列的士师
，to occupy a seat in the spirit world，
也在属灵界里能够坐在一个宝座上。
Now I am not saying we have license to live immorally. That's not what I'm saying.
我现在想的不是说我们可以过一个不道德的生活。
We are to live holy.
我们是要过一个圣洁的日子。
But God will give people restraints，
但神会给人一些特别的限制。
If they will function under those restraints，
如果他们愿意自甘在这些限制之下过
，they overcome，
他们就得胜。
And he lets them sit in a seat，
他就神就容让他们坐在那个位置上。
Let me explain to you this way，
让我用另外一个例子来跟大家分享。
God said to me， "Don't do this."
神告诉我不可以做这件事。
I have been faithful not to do this.
那在这些年，我都持续信实的不做这件事。
I believe I occupy a seat.
我相信我有一个位置。我坐在宝座上。
Rees House in Wales.
那威尔斯的 Rees House.
Yeah. Okay. He led a very powerful prayer group.
他带着一个极有能力的祷告团队。
In Wales.
在威尔斯。
And through his prayers, they actually, Winston Churchill actually credited it being very effective to help the Allied forces win World War II.
事实上，丘吉尔就极力的遵从他们，是说是因着他们的祷告使他们英国可以得胜战胜 第二次世界大战。
God would show him and his prayer group, how to pray over certain areas.
那神会向他显明如何为某一些地区。
That was going to be significant battles in World War II.
那在第二次世界大战，那些地区是非常会即将会发生极当重大的战争。
And through their prayers, the Allied forces won victories they should not have won.
所以借着他们的祷告，那个联军就盟军就赢得那些其实看为不可能的战争。
Well, Reese House said the reason they had the power to pray those kind of prayers.
那 House 就说他们能够足以做这些的祷告。
The reasons was because God had told him, "Do not wear a hat in public."
月神吩咐他不可以在公众的地方戴一个帽子。
Now in those days, for an English gentleman,
那你知道在那个时期，一个英国的绅士
to go into public without his hat on,
到公众的场合不戴帽子
it was a shameful thing,
是一个非常羞耻的事情。
And yet, Reese House said, as long as he obeyed that.
Reese House 就说他只要顺服这个命令
which made no sense logically
对于人来说这一点都不合逻辑
he had what he called
他就会拥有他所称之为的
a place of abiding
就是一个住在基督里居住在基督里的位置
he had a seat in the spirit world
他在灵界里就有一个宝座
that allowed him and his prayer group
就容纳他和他的祷告小组
to pray prayers that determine the destiny of nations
能够释放出一个祷告来改变国家的命定
because he was faithful to the restraint that God put on his life
因着他信实的持守神在他生命中所设下的限制
even when it made no sense
虽然对我们来说可能很不合逻辑
It was not about right or wrong.
这不关乎对错。
It was about obedience.
那只是关乎他的顺服。
Amen.
Amen.
William Seymour in the U.S.
那美国的 William Seymour
that gave birth and led the Azusa Street outpouring.
就是带出那阿苏萨大街大复兴的那个。
When he would pray in the meetings,
当他在聚会中祷告的时候
he put a box over his head.
他就头上戴着一个和箱子
and he would pray with his box over his head.
他祷告的时候持续都戴着这个箱子
and the glory of God would come.
在头上，那然后就看到神的荣耀进来，神迹发生
and outpourings would come.
那看到圣经大圣灵大大的浇灌
that literally birthed multiple denominational or spirit-filled denominations.
而且生出许多圣灵充满的宗派。
They told William Seymour.
他们就告诉 William Seymour 说
Please, William, take the box off your head.
请你把这个箱子拿下来吧。
Don't you know what you look like?
你知道你看起来很怪吗？
You're already a one-eyed black man.
你已经只是一个单独眼的黑人了。
Because that he did, he was a black man he was blind in one eye.
因为他是一个黑人，他有一只眼睛是瞎的。
This is not helping our reputation.
那你还这样做这种古怪动作，对我们的名声实在不怎么有帮助。
It's foolishness to think that because you pray with a box on your head, that these things are happening.
那这样的聚会，你带着这样的箱子在头上，这聚会这么多事情发生，实在看起来很愚
拙。So he took the box off his head.
所以他就把箱子拿下来。
The glory didn't come.
那荣耀就不来。
It stopped.
就走了。
Until he put the box back on his head.
直到他再把箱子戴回头上。
What was happening?
这里发生什么样的事
A restraint that let him sit in a seat.
这一个限制容让他能够坐在宝座上
Made no sense.
对我们来说不合逻辑
Logically.
逻辑上不合理
We can't go out here today and say, well, I'm going to go home and put a box on my head.
就是我们今天开始聚会，放一个箱子在我们头上。
And I'm going to pray with a box on my head.
然后我开始祷告，就带着箱子在头上。
We're going to birth a revival for Asia.
那我们就会要等着亚洲的大复兴啊。
It won't work.
那不是这样子的。
It will not work.
这若不是出于神，这不是有影响。
Because the issue was an issue of obedience for him.
因为这个。问题在乎他的顺服。
A restraint that God put on his life，
就是神放置在他生命里的一个限制。
That let him pray prayers that gave birth to that unbelievable movement，
以至于他可以做这样的祷告，生出这样一个令人惊异的神的运动。
Amen.
Amen.
So when God said for me to do what He told me to do，
所以当神吩咐我不可以做这件事的时候。
That if I would you, no, it won't work.
我刚才说，你若没有神的吩咐，这不会有功效的。
This is not what God told me to do.
这不是神叫我要做的。
You see, the reason I do what I do.
因为我做，我之所以我做我现在做的。
Is because I realize, according to the word of the angel.
因为按着天使所告诉我的话语。
It gives me a place to sit in the spirit world.
它容让我给我一个在灵界里一个位置可以做。
That lets me pray prayers I couldn't otherwise pray.
以至于我可以做一些祷告是我过往不能做的。
I mean, I can say the words.
当我可以说同样重复同样的字眼。
But they would have no real effect in the spirit dimension.
但是在灵界里却没有任何的果效。
It is the obedience that lets me sit in a seat.
因着我的顺服，才使我得以坐在我的宝座上。
For my life, when the Bible says to him that overcomes, I'll let them sit in the seat.
那圣经告诉我们说，凡得胜的，我就给他宝，赐他宝座，坐在我的宝座。
It is that God comes and gives you a specific word so graciously.
就是神把一个很特别的任务交给你。
That if I'll just obey that, I overcome.
我只要单单顺服在这个任务，我就得胜。
I'll be able to function in a realm I couldn't function in otherwise.
我就得以可以在一个领域里面运作，是我过往不行。
So I began to function in this realm.
所以我就开始在这样一个领域。
I then was invited to speak at a conference in Arizona in the U.S.
后来有一次我在美国受邀到Arizona 这一州去服事。
When I got to this conference, an African brother that led the conference.
那当我到了这个特会的时候，有一个非洲的弟兄。
He's a man of great revelation.
他是一个有极大启示的弟兄。
And when I get there, he tells me, God has been speaking to me about restraining orders in the spirit world.
那当我去到特会的时候，他就来跟我说，神过往曾经告诉他说，在灵界的里面怎么样一个限制力。
And he says to me, he says, if it's, I would like to ask your permission to write a book and to teach on receipt or getting restraining orders in place from the courts of heaven.
那我他就跟我说，我是否可以得到你的允许，让我写一本书，就是关乎从天上法庭所领受的限制力。
And I said to him, you don't need my permission.
他说你，我就跟他说，你不需要我的允许。
He said, oh no, no, I do.
他说不，我真的需要。
You are the father of this message.
他说因为你是这一套信息的。
When I heard that, I knew he understood something about protocol in the spirit world.
所以当我一听到的时候，我就知道他其实在灵界里知道那个次序礼仪。
I said, well, sure.
我说当然了。
Absolutely.
可以啊。
So when he stands up to minister, he looks at me. I'm sitting on the front row.
所以当他开始站在台上服事的时候，他就看着我。那时候我坐在第一排。
And he says to the people, "I want you to know something."
他就跟大家说，我希望大家知道一件事。
This man is a judge in the spirit world.
这个人他是在灵界里的一个审判官。
Now he had no idea about my dreams.
事实上，他根本不知道我曾经做。
Or what I just shared with you about my understanding of these things.
或者我跟刚刚大家所分享我对这些事的。
But when he said it, I knew it was true.
当他说的时候，我就知道他所说的是真的。
It was like the pieces came together.
就好像那些拼图被组在一起。
And I began to realize God is looking to set some people in places as judges.
那我就开始明白，神定义将有一些人设立在灵界里头，如同
that there are thrones that are in place.
就是说，宝座已经设立好。
But He needs the right people to fill them.
他需要正确的人能够坐在上面。
So that the court of heaven can operate at its highest level.
以至于天上的法庭能够以最高的等次来进行。
Amen.
Amen.
Let me show you one scripture before we go into that deeper.
让我们走进到更深之前。
It's in 1 Corinthians chapter 2.
就是哥林多前书第二章。
Where Paul tells us about operating as a judge.
就是保罗告诉我们如何以一个审判官的位分来。
Let's just read verse 14.
第十四节。
But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness to him, nor can he know them because they are spiritually discerned.
然而属血气的人不领会神圣灵的事，反倒以为愚拙，并且不能知道，因为这些事唯有属灵的人才能看透。
But he who is spiritual judges all things, yet he himself is rightly judged by no one.
属灵的人能看透万事，却没有一人能看透了他。
For who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him, but we have the mind of Christ?
谁曾知道主的心去教导他呢？但我们是有基督的心了。
We're going to talk about that later on.
我们等等会讲到。
But I just want you to see.
所以我但是首先要大家看见。
He who is spiritual.
那属灵的人。
Judges all things.
能看透万事。
That is the Greek word krino.
那希腊文字是 krino.
And it means to judicially judge.
就是在司法上来审判。
You see, even the Apostle Paul says God wants us to judge.
甚至使徒保罗告诉我们说，神要我们来审判。
Now, I know here, I know in America.
我知道在美国
or, and maybe here with you guys in China and Hong Kong.
也许在华人的社会香港生活的
时候 When you hear someone say, judge,
当我们听到有人说审判
our minds go to Matthew chapter 7.
那我们马上想到马太福音
Judge not, lest you be judged.
就是我们不要论断人免得我们
不要论断 We're not supposed to judge.
我们不应该论断呢、啊
That's what we think.
这就我们马上会想到。
But maybe we've heard it taught.
而且我们也领受这样的教导。
I have no right to judge.
我哪有权柄可以论断别人审判？
But Paul says you do.
但圣灵告诉我们，保罗告诉我们是。
Paul says that if you're spiritual,
如果你是属灵的人
，if you're under the control of the Holy Spirit,
若你顺服在圣灵的带领之下
，you can judge all things.
你可以看透万事。
You can operate and even sit as a judge.
你甚至可以坐在宝座上运行，如同一个审判官。
Because you have the mind of Christ.
因为你有知道主的心。
But simply that no, I can't judge.
但是我们觉得我们不能论断呢。
Matthew 7:1 says.
马太福音第七章那样告诉我们。
Judge not, lest you be judged.
你不可以论断人，免得你们遭人论断。
If we don't understand this,
如果我们不明白这个道理
，we're going to forfeit a true realm of function that God needs for us to function in.
就是我们要放弃一个神其实很希望我们能够运作的一个领域。
So let's look at Matthew 7.
好吧，让我们看一下马太福音第七章。
And let's see what Jesus actually said here.
我们看看耶稣到底在那里说了什么。
Because God needs for us to take our place as judges.
因为谁要我们站在一个审判官的位置
Matthew 7 verses 1 through 4.
马太福音第七章
Actually 5.
一到五节
Judge not that you be not judged.
你们不要论断人，免得你们被论断
And everybody says, "See there."
那大家都说看吧
Don't do it.
不要这样做
Well, let's keep going.
但是我们看
往下看 For with what judgment you judge, you will be judged.
因为你们怎样论断人，也必怎样被论断。
And with the measure you use, it will be measured back to you.
你们用什么量器量给人，也必用什么量器量给你们。
So let me just say right here.
所以我们在这里停一下。
If we are guilty ourselves,
如果我们本身是有罪疚的
then we can't judge.
我们真的没有办法论断。
Because if I judge something,
若因为我如果审判是
that I myself am guilty of,
但是我在这件事上其实我有犯罪
the enemy has a legal right to bring that judgment back on me.
那仇敌就有一个合法的立足点，把这样同样的审判。
Because that is the standard of Scripture.
因为就按着圣经的标准来说。
When he says, "Judge not, lest you be judged,"
就是我们不要论断人，免得我们被论断。
He's speaking to us that if we have got discrepancies in our own life,
意思就是说，若我们的生命中有亏缺。
I cannot be used to render judgment.
我就没有办法被主使用来施行审判。
Because if I do,
因为我若如此
，what I speak against something will come back to me.
凡是我所说出来的话，必会成为一个攻击我的事。
This is what the Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 11.
这就是保罗在哥林多前书第十一章那里所说的。
That God literally judges us, so we won't be judged with the world.
因为神要审判我们，以致我们不落在世界的审判之下。
That God comes and does a cleansing work in our life.
所以神在我们生命中诸般洁净的工作。
So that when the judgment comes on the world, it doesn't have to come on us.
所以那当世界的审判临到的时候，就不会在我们身上找到任何。
This is what Peter said. First Peter chapter 5.
这也是彼得在彼得前书第五章那里所说的。
Judgment first begins at the house of God.
那审判是从神的家中开始的。
For if it first begins at us, what will be the end of the earth, basically, end of the world?
那从我们开始直到世界的地极。
In other words, God will take us through a purifying process.
意思就是说，神要带领我们经过一个洁净的过程。
So He can legally judge the world and he won't have to judge us.
以至于到之后他可以合法的来审判全世界，然而属于他的百姓不落在那个审判之下。
Because that's the principle of scripture.
这就是圣经所告诉
的。So let's continue.
让我们继续往下看第三节。
And why do you look at the speck in your brother's eye, but do not consider the plank in your own eye?
为什么看见你弟兄眼中有刺，却不想自己眼中有梁木？
Or how can you say to your brother, "Let me remove the speck from your eye, and look, a plank is in your own eye"?
那你自己眼中有梁木，怎能对你的弟兄说，容我去让你眼中的刺呢？
So the reason Jesus is talking about the eye,
所以为什么耶稣讲到眼睛？
Is because we judge by what we evaluate.
因为我们审判根据我们所我们的评估。
So he says, if I say to someone,
所以如果我对某人说
，Come here, let me get that speck out of your eye.
来来来，我把你眼中的刺拿出来。
But I've got this log in mine.
但是在我的眼中有一个超大的梁木。
Then I can't see clearly to get it out of his.
那我就没有办法清楚的看见帮助我的弟兄除去他眼中的刺。
Because I'm being blinded by what's in mine.
因为我眼中的梁木使我瞎了眼。
I can't.Judge effectively and righteously.
我就没有办法在公义和功效的里面来施行审判。
So Jesus says.
因此耶稣说
，Don't worry about the speck in his.
就不要担心你弟兄眼中的刺。
Get the plank out of yours.
你首先必须除去你眼中的。
Verse five.
第五节。
Hypocrite, first remove the plank from your own eye.And then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye.
你这假冒为善的人，先去掉自己眼中的梁木，然后才能看得清楚，去掉你眼中的刺。
In other words, if you will go through the process,
意思说，若我们经历这样的一个过程
，you will then be qualified to judge.
你就才得以合格，能够施行审判。
You see, you got to read the whole court. The whole thing is being said here.
所以我们必须要整段来看。
Jesus is not saying never judge.
耶稣不是告诉我们永远不能来施行审判。
He's saying don't try to judge when you're guilty of the same thing.
就是说，若你 若你在同样一个罪上有份，你就不能施行审判，或更糟的罪上有份。
First, get things right in your own life.
首先，我们要先把自己的生命来对齐。
Then you will have a perspective that will allow you to judge correctly.
以至于我们才有一个正确的看见，容让我们施行出正确的审判。
Amen.
Amen.
So we are called to judge.
所以我们蒙召是要来。施行审判。
We are called to sit in positions of authority in the spirit world.
我们蒙召是要来坐在灵界里一个属灵审判的宝座上。
Even occupy thrones.
甚至是要坐在来得着我们的宝座。
And render judge a judgment.
从那里来施行审判。
Because you can never have justice without judgment.
如果没有审判的话，你就永远得不着公义。
Justice is always a result of judgment, right judgment.
那公义的乃是正确审判的结果。
Amen.
Amen.
Let me tell you a quick story.
让我跟大家分享一个很快的故事。
Years ago, in the Apostolic Center that we raised up.
那在多年前，在我们建立的使徒新中心。
I had two ministers.That in different situations were in trouble.
有两个传道人在陷入不同的问题里。
One had been on the missionary field down in Peru.
那一个是到了 Peru 这一个宣教工厂里。
And he and his family were in bad financial situation.
那他和他的家人就陷入极大经济的困难。
So I believed in him.
我因为信任他。
So we gave them $3,000 a month.
那我每一个月就奉献，就给他3000块钱。
To support them.While they were on the field in Peru,
就是当他们在这个宣教工厂的时候，每个月资助他们3000块。
When they came back from Peru,
当从 Peru 回来的时候
because I believe that you support the man, not necessarily just the mission.
因为我相信支持这个人不单单是支持他的事工。
He came back and said, "I feel like God has called me to plant churches for me and this ministry."He wanted to plant churches for me in the ministry.
那他就想要在为了我和这个事工来建一个堂。
We were an apostolic house. That's what we did.
那这是因为我们是使徒性中心，这就是我们。
I said awesome.
我说很棒啊。
I'll keep giving you the money.
我会持续资助。
And I'll give you ministries that we have raised up here.
那我们在这里兴起的事工。
We'll provide as much resources as we can.
那我们会尽力的提供各式的资源。
We'll send a team with you.
我们也会差派一个团队。
To go plant churches in different areas.
那在不同的地区开始建堂。
So that's what we did.
这就是我们所做的。
With this particular individual.
跟这一个人。
The other guy.
那另外一个人呢
？Had a much bigger church than what I had.
他拥有的教会比我的大很多。
He was down in Austin, Texas.
他住在 Austin 这个地方。
And all of a sudden, and we would go down to be a part of some of their events.
那事实上我们会去参加他们一些的活动。
A very strong apostolic work.
他们拥有很厉害的使徒。
But I had a dream one night.
有一天晚上我做了一个梦。
And in my dream, this man is stripped naked and in my bed.
那有一天，那我就梦见这个人赤身露体的躺在我的床上。
And my wife is in the bed.
然后我的太太也躺在床上。
But I knew it wasn't something sexual.
我知道这个所里面的含义不是在性方面。
I knew he had been stripped naked of everything.
我在灵里的领受是说他一切所拥有的都被剥夺。
And I woke up.
所以我就醒来之后。
Within a week.
一个礼拜不到。
The men that were with him in the ministry.
那跟他一起合作的。
They rose up against him.
他们就兴起来抵挡。
And they stripped him of everything.
就剥夺了他一切。
They took his church from him.
拿走他的
They took his finances.
他的经济来
They took everything.
所有一切都拿走
He was naked.
他真的被剥到赤身
He and his wife are trying to figure out what to do.
他和他妻子就尝试
And I would kind of know what was going on.
那其实我
And the Lord spoke to me.
我就跟主就
He said, I told you he was in your bed.
主就跟我说，我早就告诉你他在你的床上
I want you to invite him to come here.
我要你来邀请他们到你这里。
And I want you to take care of him.
我要你来照顾他。
And I want you to give him a place of safety.
我要你给他一个安全之处。
Which is what it meant being in my bed.
意思就是在我就好像在我床上。
So I did that.
所以我就按着。
So he came.
他来。
Everything was good for a while.
一阵子都看起来。
In the process of maybe two or three years, I don't remember.
大概两三年之。
This guy from Peru.
那从。Peru 来
and this other guy.
还有这个人
They all get together.
后来他们两个聚在一起
I have given them places to minister in the church.
那我给他们教会里面服事的位置
They're good ministers.
他们是很好的
One leads the Bible school.
一个带领我们的圣经学院
The other ministers in different capacities.
那另外一个人就在不同的地方
But they get together.
但之后他们联手
They decide.
他们决定
They're going to break away.
他们决定脱离我们
And start their own church.
开始自己的教会
Well,In the same city,
在同一个城市
not being sent out,
不是我们差派他们出去
just going to do it,
而是他们自己想
And here was the deal, I knew where they intended to get their first people.
我知道他们的羊要从哪里来的
because I had given them influence in people's lives.
因为我给他们影响力在我教会里面的人
I was very grieved over it.
那我为此就极度的忧伤。
I was so grieved over it.
我非常忧伤。
Not because I was necessarily afraid of losing people.
不是因为我害怕失去羊。
I knew that this was not good for the kingdom of God in this area.
我知道这对整个附近的地区来说，对整个国
家。It wasn't going to say the right thing. It wasn't going to say the right thing.
那不是说要说对的事。
So, I know I need to judge it.
所以我知道我必须要在这件事情上。
I was a little bit aware of this principle.
那我很留，我知道这个原则。
I knew I needed to judge it.
我知道我必须要是审判。
I'll never forget.
我永远不会忘记。
I was praying one morning.
有一天早上我祷告。
I was walking along the wall by myself.
我就沿着墙自己走。
I'm a walker.
我是一个很喜欢走路的人。
I was praying as I walked.
那当我一面走路一面祷告。
And all of a sudden, the presence of God came.
突然之间，神同在临到。
And God said to me instantly.
神突然就立即告诉我。
He said very clearly.
清楚地说。
Judge it now.
现在审判。
But then he said this.
然后他这样说。
But don't touch my servants.
但是不要触摸我的仆人，不要动我的。
Clear.
很清楚。
Now I knew he was saying.Judge the work they intend to start.
就是说，神吩咐我要来审判他们即将要开始进行的工作。
But do not judge the men, their mind.
但是不要审判那些人，因为他们是属乎神的。
Now you gotta know.
你必须要知道。
I did want to touch them.
我真的很想。
But I knew God was telling me.
但是我知道
If you judge them,
但是若你审判他们,
it's going to be from the log that's in your eye.
那却是从你眼中的梁木,
you're hurt, you're wounded, you're offended.
愿你现在受伤, 你想要自卫,
and it's going to cause judgment to come back on you.
那如果你这样做的话, 那个审判反而会临到你自己。
So don't touch them.
所以不要触摸他们。
So I remember I stood there. I remember.
我就很记得清楚，我就站在那里。
I remember the exact words I said.
我就记得我口中所说出来的话。
I said, Lord, as I stand before you.
说，我就说主啊，当我站在你的面前。
I judge this work that is intended to be started.
我审判这即将要开始的工作。
I judge it as illegal and as unrighteous.
我宣告他们是不公义、不合法的。
And I call it.To the ground before it even began.
我宣告他们还没开始之前，他们就倒在地上。
And I knew it was done.
我就知道你做成了。
That week,
那个礼拜
within days,
就几天之后
the group that was gathered,
就本来他们招聚了一群人
it got all upset with each other and began to splinter.
然后因为里面的争吵就开始自分散了。
That was 20 years ago. It never started.
这个二十年前的事情，他们从来没有开始。
Because I judged it as illegal and as unrighteous.
因为我审判他们是不合法，然后是不公义的。
But I didn't touch the servants.
但是我却没有触摸那些仆人。
Because you got to understand when we operate as judge.
因为你必须要明白，当我们
It is always within the parameters that the Holy Spirit gives.
那总是要在圣灵所量给我们的局限范围里。
See, God is the judge of all.
因为神才是那审判全地的。
I am not.
我不是。
You are not.
你也不是。
He can judge it all.
他可以审判全地。
We have to stay within the parameters.That are given to us in the spirit.
那我们必须要按着圣灵所量给我们在灵里那个限度的范围的里面
来审判。When we endeavor to function as judges,
我们才能够施行呢审判官的责任。
Does that make sense?
大家明白我在说什么吗
？So back in Daniel.
所以我们再回到但以书。
The seats.Or put into place. The thrones are set.
我们看到那个宝座已经设立好了。
Okay, that means there's now thrones that need to be occupied.
意思就是说，现在已经宝座有坐设立好了，需要有人坐上去。
So God is looking for people who can get in those thrones.
所以神在寻找那些得以配得坐在那些宝座上的人。
It says the Ancient of Days was seated.
那上面写的说上头坐着各种
人。It talks about who he is and what he does.
那讲到形容他是谁，他做了什么。
And let me just show you this.
然后他告诉我们显
明。It says in verse 10, a fiery stream issued and came forth from before him.
第十节，从他面前有火向何发出来。
Okay, those are verdicts coming out of the court.
这就是从天上法庭所出来的判决。
Fiery streams coming from the court.
火河从天上法庭出来。
Are the verdicts that are coming as the court operates?
就是当法庭在运作时候所发出来的各个的。
I believe it's Psalms 92.
我相信在诗篇九十二篇。
A fire goes before him and burns up his enemies.
就是火行在他的前面，而且他的仇敌都被烧尽。
You see, one of the things God wants to do in the courts.
神在天上法庭想要做的。
Is that there can be a release of judgment that destroys God's enemies?
就是释放出一些裁决，使神的仇敌都消灭。
These are entities in the spirit world.
这些就是在灵界里面所发生的一些。
Because God loves human beings.
因为神爱世人。
But if human beings will not get out of agreement with these spirit beings,
但是若世人不脱离他们与邪灵的一切的同意，
then they can become judged as well.
那他们可能就会落在神，他们就会落在神的审判之下。
Remember Acts 12.
你记得《使徒行传》第十二章。
When Herod sits upon his seat,
当希律王坐在他宝座上
，and gives an oration to the people,
就发出一个口谕。
And the people began to cry out, "The voice of a god and not man."
那个从地上就出来一个呼声。
Now Herod has done so much wickedness.
那希律王多行恶事。
I mean, he beheaded James.
那甚至把那个雅各的头都砍掉。
He was going to kill Peter if the angel didn't deliver him.
如果那个天使没有救彼得的话，那个彼得也小命不保。
I mean, this is a wicked.Wicked man.
这是一个充满邪恶的人。
But let me just show you this. in Acts 15.
那我们看一下《使徒行传》第十五章。
I mean, if I was God,
如果我是神的话
，I would have judged him a long time ago.
我很早就搞他，审判他。
I mean, if killing James was not a right to judge him,
那杀了雅各都还不足以来审判他的话
，then where was it?
那还有什么
？It's actually Acts 12.
事实上，对不起，《使徒行传》第十二章。
And so we watch here in Acts 12.
所以我们看到《使徒行传》第十二章。
It says in verse 21.
第二十一节。
So on a set day, Herod, arrayed in royal apparel, sat on his throne and gave an oration to them.
那希律在锁定的日子，穿上朝服，坐在位上，对他们讲论了一番。
And the people kept shouting, "The voice of a god and not of a man."
那百姓就喊着说，这是神的声音，不是人的声音呢。
Then immediately an angel of the Lord struck him because he did not give glory to God, and he was eaten by worms and died.
因为希律不归荣耀与神，所以主的使者立刻把他就被虫所咬，气就绝了。
I'm like, what?
我就想哈。
Wait, he is killing all of God's people.
他已经杀了这个神的百姓。
He's doing all these evil, unbelievable things.
他做了这么多和可怕邪恶的事情。
Things we couldn't even imagine.
那个我们想都想不出来的邪恶。
And because he didn't say, "Oh, the glory goes to God."
只是单单因为他没有把荣耀归给神。
That's what flipped God's switch.
那就是神那时候审判他吗？
It was like this. I mean, when I look at this smaller thing,
我就觉得哇，跟那些事情比起来，这个好像很小啊。
People don't give glory to God every day.
那你知道我们旁边很多人每一天都把荣耀归给神
了。This is what got on God's nerve.
那这就是使神挑动神审判的那根筋吗？
But see, I think what actually happened here.
那我觉得在那里确实发生的事。
That was the thing. That was the thing that filled up the iniquity.
其实那是最后，等于是把那个不义的碗所填满的最后一根稻草吧。
God is so righteous.
因为神是如此的公义。
That He can only judge when there's enough iniquity to warrant it, to cry for it.
唯有那不义的碗被足够的是不义的，足够不义的时候，神才会来施行审判。
That's why we think, why is God not judging?
所以为什么我们常常觉得，为什么神还不审判？
Because by His nature, He's merciful.
因为神他的本性乃是充满怜悯。
But He has to wait for there to be enough suffering and sin to warrant His judgment.
但是他必须要等有足够的痛苦跟罪孽，以至于他才开始施行。
Let me show you this principle.
那我给大家看这个。
Colossians chapter 1, and we'll finish it with this one more scripture.
哥罗西书第一章。
Colossians chapter 1.
哥罗西书第一章。
You see, the reason I'm sharing this.
为什么我跟大家这样分享
？Is if it's not time to judge, we can't call for it.
如果审判的时间还没有到的时候，我们就没有办法把审判。
I cannot judge something God's not judging.
就是当神还没有审判的时候，我也审判不了。
Now, if God is judging it and He needs for me to judge it, that's another thing.
但是如果神要施行审判，他也需要我来审判的时候，那是另外一回事。
Then that can actually stop the judgment from not coming.
而且我也可以有能力使审判不临到。
Because God needs somebody, in the earth to speak that judgment into place.
哦，因为如果神在地上没有找到一个人可以来口中宣告出神的审判的话，
if,
可能拦阻神的审判。
If God is not judging yet,
但是若神在这件事情上还没有施行审判，
I can't judge what He's not judging.
我也就没有办法施行任何的审判。
See, somehow or another, when Herod got judged,
就当希律王受审的时候，
it was like that was the last little thing that God needed.
好像这是最后填满他不义碗的最后一件事。
To be able to render judgment.
以至于神就开始立即查他。哥罗西书第一章。
Verse 24.
二十四节。
Paul said, "I now rejoice in my sufferings for you and fill up in my flesh what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ for the sake of His body, which is the church."
现在我为你们受苦，倒觉欢乐，并且为基督的身体，就是为教会，要在我肉身上补满基督患难的缺。
I read this scripture.
我读这节经文。
And I think, wait a minute.
我就想，等一下。
Jesus hung on the flat on the cross.
当耶稣被钉在十字架上。
Said it is finished.
他说成了。
And yet Paul is saying,
但保罗却在这里说,
he is filling up what is lacking in the afflictions of Christ.
就是他在补满基督患难的缺欠。
Well, I thought Jesus already suffered, and everything he did was enough for complete and total redemption.
那我就觉得耶稣在十字架上受了这么多的苦，而且他已经做成了他一切的功了。
Nothing else needs to be added to it.
那还有什么需要补缺的吗？
That is true.
是真的。
See, for redemption, for the salvation.
为了我们的救赎和救恩。
Enough is done.
的确
All that Jesus went through on the cross.
耶稣上了十字架，他所做的就足够。
It was everything God needed.
这就是神所需要的一切。
To judge sin.
来审判罪。
And to redeem man.
而救赎人。
And even his creation.
甚至所有受造之物。
But you need to understand something.
但必须明白一件事。
For God to judge the world.
神要来审判世界。
In other words, for him to render righteous judgment.
就是说神要来赐下公义的审判。
Paul said there's not been enough suffering yet.
那保罗在这里就告诉我们说还有我们的患难还不足。
He said I am having to suffer for in the Lord.
我要来为主受苦。
To fill up what is necessary.
来补足一切所需要的。
So God can then righteously judge the earth.
以至于神可以来公义的审判全世界。
You see, guys, please get this.
请大家要认识这一点。
Our suffering has purpose.
我们的受苦乃是有目的的。
That's what, now, this is why Peter said that we are not to suffer, if any man suffer as a Christian.
就是当一个基督徒受苦，彼得说。
I mean, if I'm suffering because of my own wrongness.
如果因我自己的亏欠我犯的罪而受苦
That's one thing.
这是一回事
But if I am going through hardship no matter what it is because I'm a Christian
但是若因为我是基督徒的身份而经历种种的苦难的话
Then that is filling up the necessary quota that God has
那这里是来补足神所需要的这个患难受苦的部分
To be able to righteously judge the earth
才能够来公义的来审判世界
And free it from all injustice.
那使我们脱离一切的不公义。
This is why Paul is saying this.
这是保罗在这里所说的。
I realize my suffering has purpose in it.
我就明白我的受苦原来是有意的。
Not only is God using my suffering to refine me.
不单单神使我经历苦难，使我更加的炼净。
My suffering is granting God a legal right to render righteous judgments in the earth.
而且我的受苦使神有一个合法的权益，公义的来审判。
Let me show you one more scripture.
我再给大家另外一个经文。
Genesis 15.
创世纪第十五章。
We'll finish with this.
让我们借此来结束这一堂。
We cannot judge.
我们没有办法审判。
What God's not judging.
就是当神还没有审判的时候。
That if things are not completely in the place,
就是若事情还没有完全就位,
then we have to be aware of that will come.
我们必须要留意这样的事情, 必将
到。 In Genesis 15,
创世纪第十五章,
Abraham is put into a trance.
那神把亚伯兰进入到一个魂游向外的位置,
and
光景,
and he is told that God's going to give him the land.
那神要把地赐给他。
But that his descendants would spend 400 years in captivity.
但是他的后裔必要四百年为奴。
That was going to be to Egypt.
就是要在埃及为奴。
But that God would bring them out.
但是最终神要把地赐。
And he would bring them and he would give them this land.
那之后要把那个地赐给他。
Okay, Genesis 15.
创世纪第十五章。
And let's just read verse 13.
让我们读十三节。
Then he said to Abraham, No.Certainly that your descendants will be strangers in a land that is not theirs and will serve them and they will afflict them for 400 years.
耶和华对亚伯兰说你要的确知道你的后裔必寄居别人的地又服侍那地的人那地的人要苦待他们四百年。
And also the nation whom they serve I will judge.
并且他们所要服侍的那国我要惩罚。
Afterwards, they shall come out with great possessions.
后来他们必带着许多的财物从那里出来。
God did that.
神自己做的。
He judged Egypt.
他审罚了埃及。
And God said, or Moses told them, ask from your neighbor all their stuff.
那摩西告诉所有的 以色列人说，你跟你的邻舍拿他们的财物。
So they came out with all the possessions of Egypt.
所以他们把埃及所有的财物都带出了。
God's telling Abraham this, you know, many, many years before.
那神在这里在很多年之前就已经把这件事情给亚伯兰看。
Now as for you, you shall go to your fathers in peace, and you shall be buried at a good old age.
第十五节，但你要享大寿数，平平安平平安安的回到你列祖那里，被人埋葬。
Verse 16.
第十六节。
But in the fourth generation, they shall return here.
到了第四代，他们必回到此地。
In other words, your descendants will now come back to this land.
意思就是说，你的后裔必要回到这个地方。
For the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet full.
因为亚摩利人的罪孽还没有满盈。
God says, Abraham, the reason I can't give you the land now.
神告诉亚伯兰说，为什么现在没有办法把这地给你？
Is because there is not enough sin and wickedness among the inhabitants of the land.
因为在当地居住的人，他们的罪孽还没有满足。
For me to righteously judge them and cast them out and give it to you.
使我能够施行公义的审判，把他们从这地驱逐之地，把这地赐给你。
It's going to take four more generations.Of unrighteous living by these people.
还要花四代他们这样不公义、罪孽的活在这些地上，才足以。
Before I can legally and righteously judge this thing.
以至于我可以合法的和公义的来审判这地的罪。
And fulfill my word.
来成就我对你的应许。
And give you this land.
将这地赐给你。
Wow.
Wow.
We have to understand.
我们必须要明白。
God has to have the right to render judgment.
神必须要有一个合法的权利来赐下审判。
There has to be a filling up of a quota before Him.
在神的面前，那个罪必须要满盈了，他才可以施行。
That allows those judgments to come.
才容让这样的审判临到。
So I have to be sensitive when I'm operating as a judge.
所以当我如同一个审判官在运作的时候，我要留意。
To whether God is truly judging something now.
是留意神是否现在在审判某些。
Now Abraham says that, or God says Abraham.
神对亚伯兰说。
Now you're going to live a great life.
你会过一个很棒的日生命。
You're going to live a good old age.
你会得享长寿。
But as a nation, the nation I'm giving birth to,
但至于我借着你所生出来这个国，
it will not be able to fully come into its destiny.
它没有办法完全进入到它的命定。
Until the iniquity of the Amorites is full.
直到亚摩利人他们的罪恶满盈。
Now, I don't know when those things are.
老实说，我也不知道这些什么时候。
Only God knows.
唯有神知道。
You see, you would have thought God would have judged Herod.
那你以为神早就会审判希律了吧？
I mean, what he'd already done.
他看他所做的那些事情。
It was just like this last little thing.
好像那个最后那一点。
This last little grain of sand.
那最后一粒沙。
And the scale went.
然后那个天平就砰。
And the Bible says that Herod was struck immediately.
那圣经告诉我们说，神就立刻的惩罚他。
Because everything God needed to judge him now was in place.
所以，因为神所需要合法来审判他的一切条件都已经就位。
If God has a church,
如果神有教会
that is standing before Him in right place,
如今站立在他的面前，站立在他们对的位置上。
And wickedness within a nation is still being allowed.
那然而国中。那些不行邪恶的事情仍然是。
That's because there is something yet not done that will allow God to legally judge it.
就表示有一些事情还没有做成，以至于神还没有办法。
And with the Amorites, it was going to take four more generations.
对于亚摩利人来说，他们还需要四代的时间。
Now, I don't think that's true for us.
对我们来说，可能不是。
But I'm just saying, regardless of the timetable and of the quota that's involved.
那不管神的时间表和我天上法庭需要什么
，We cannot judge something before God is.
就是我们没有办法行在神的面前。
So tonight, we're gonna go deeper tonight.
所以今天晚上我们是会。
And we're gonna talk about how to get into that place of being a judge.
那我们会讲到如如何进入到一个审判官的位置，占据我们的位置。
But these are some principles.
但这些是我们所需要知道的原则。
That will help us understand how to function there.
那使我们明白如何在法庭上运作。
Amen. So would you stand with me?
好不好？让我们一起站起来。
Father, we just want to thank you.
天父，我们只想谢谢你。
want to thank you that you are moving us from being a defendant.
我们感谢你把我们从一个被告人的身份。
You are moving us to be a judge.
把我们挪到一个审判官的位置。
You need us to function in that place.
你需要我们在这一个位份上来。
We thank you that you're taking out of our eyes the log.
主，我谢谢你把我们眼中的梁木挪去。
So that we can see clearly how to judge.
以致我们可以清楚看见。
So that we can set righteous judgments into place.
以致我们可以把公义的审判施下。
Father, we thank you for this.
主，我们为此来感谢。
We thank you that we are not meant.
我们感谢你，因为我们本来受造。
To live a life of condemnation.
不是在一个被控诉的光景下
过日子。We are called.
我们蒙召。
To be seated in heavenly places with you.
坐在与你坐在同坐在天上的宝座上。
Thank you for that, Lord.
我们为此来感谢。
That we don't just function in anointing.
我们不单单是在恩膏中运行。
Not just in authority.
也不单单是在权柄下运行。
But we take our seat as judges.
我们乃是。坐在那审判官的宝座上。
Thrones are in place. Thrones are in place.
就是宝座已经被设立了。
They're waiting for the right ones to occupy.
他们等候那正确的人就位。
Let me just remind you of this.
让我来提醒大家。
This process I showed you.
我刚刚跟大家所分享的过程。
You see in David's life.
你看见那大卫的生命就是如此。他被膏三次。
He was anointed by Samuel.
他撒母耳膏他
in the midst of his brothers.
就是当他在他的兄弟之中膏他
He was then anointed at Hebron,
然后在希伯伦他受膏
which means a seat of association.
意思就是那一个相连的一个位置
It means there was an alignment.
就意思有对齐
And he began to function in authority.
他就开始在权柄之中运作
But then the third anointing was when he took the throne in Jerusalem.
但是当他最后在耶路撒冷登基的时候他再次受膏
So he moved through this process.
所以他自己也经过这样的一个过程
God wants to move us.
神要来使我们经历
He wants to move us.
他想要来使我们推动
Into seats of judicial governmental authority.
推动我们进入到一个治理司法跟立法的位置上
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I believe that tonight before we're done
我相信今天晚上我们结束之前
I'm going to try to leave enough time
我要尝试留足够的时间
To actually impart
来分次
To actually impart tonight
今天晚上来分次
And pray that God would move us into these next places.
然后祷告神会把我们带推往下一个我们需要去的位置。
That we wouldn't just be anointed.
我们就不单单受膏。
We wouldn't just have authority.
我们不单单存在权柄。
But we would be able to sit in a seat.
而是我们能够足够坐在我们的宝座上。
And judge things.
然后来审判。
In cooperation with God.
与神合作。
As a part of the court system of heaven.
成为天上司法系统的一部分。
That there are thrones.That are in place,
就是宝座已经设立
waiting for the right ones to occupy.
来等候正确的人坐在上面
So we thank you, Lord,
所以主我们谢谢你
for doing this,
做成此事
and that you will allow us,
那你会容让我们
to take our seat,
来坐在我们的位置上
We ask that you would do this.
我们向你求
主 It's not by might,
不是借着势力
It's not by power,
不是借着才能
but it's by my spirit, says the Lord.
主说乃是借着我的灵风能成事
I decree it's by your spirit.
所以我因此我宣告说是借着你的圣灵借这个地方
They shall be occupied.
这些地方必须要被
We thank you for that.
我们为此来感谢
In Jesus